The crosswalk in front of the therapeutic school was legendary. Our school occupied two small buildings, one on either side of the road. While the street didn't have too much traffic, it was a long straightaway and cars would often cruise by going over the speed limit. Crossing the street in that spot wasn't safe without a crosswalk, but the crosswalk hadn't always been there. Several years before I started working there, a student at the school complained to her teacher that it felt unsafe to cross the road between the two school buildings. The teacher responded, "I think we can do something about that." Together, the student and the teacher looked up information on the town website about which department was in charge of creating crosswalks. The teacher helped the student draft and revise a letter, and they sent it off to the town office. A few weeks later, students arrived at school to see the freshly painted white lines of a new crosswalk. The most amazing thing about the project is the role it took on in the narrative about our school. Teachers and students who weren't at the school when the crosswalk was painted would point it out often, saying, "A student at our school put that crosswalk in." The crosswalk became a symbol for student activism at our school. "Look," we'd say, "that crosswalk is here because of a student like you. What change do you want to make?" I loved telling new students about the crosswalk. I could see them processing the information as we stepped on its painted lines, filing something away for later. The people here think that students can make a difference. The crosswalk was a visible signal of our values as a school. A crosswalk on a side street in a small town in Vermont doesn't change the world or end injustice. The advocacy process doesn't fix all of the students' challenges in life. But it did make a concrete change in our community, and the legacy of the project has ripple effects that still touch students today. For me, as a new staff member, the crosswalk symbolized possibility. In a trauma-informed school, the past and the present are important. The challenging experiences we go through shape who we are. By creating trauma-informed environments, we recognize and honor those realities. But trauma-informed practices are also future-focused. I learned from the story of the crosswalk that our school was a place where we helped students make their mark on the world around them. The sense of possibility shaped who I am as a teacher, and I saw it shape so many students who passed through those doors and over that crosswalk.